What's going on, everybody? Janzadze back again to bring you Bleach episode 31 spoilers that we get from the website with the synopsis. So I'll show you some few pictures and give you my take and excitement for this episode, because something big is happening in this episode. And no, it's not Aizen. So stick around, find out, hit that like, that subscribe, and as always, people, let's get into the intro, shall we? Right, as I said, big things for this episode. We're going to go through the screenshots, we're going to read the synopsis, and then we're going to get onto my thoughts, because there's something huge that you're just not going to expect. And depending on who's watching this, you'll probably be disappointed, but you know, if you're a fan of me, you should already know what's coming up. But anyway, let's get into it with the synopsis first, giving us Yuach, or Yuha, old habits, okay? Yuha absorbed the Soul King, a torrent of power overflowing from his body, turning into a muddy, pitch-black current that attacked the Soul Society. The current covered the soul-blocking membrane, which is the, the shield around the Cerate. The turret covered the soul-blocking membrane and filled the Earth. The Earth, okay, good job, Google Translate. They were a swarm of giant, humanoid, eyeball-like beings that bared their fangs at the Shinigami, the enemies of the Quincy. The members of the Gotei 13 fought back, but were gradually engulfed by the endless, overwhelming power. Peering before the desperate Shinigami was Aizen Sosuke, the former captain of Division 5 and a criminal who committed a high treason by leading the Arrancars against the Shinigami. What was Kyoraku's goal in taking Aizen out of prison? Banger! Absolute banger. If that doesn't sell you on the episode, then I don't know what. Well, I mean, if that doesn't sell you on the episode, I got you for the next one, right? Because, as it says in the synopsis, Aizen is back, baby. He's back, and there's going to be a swarm of muddy eyes. And you see this within the PV of Call 3, which is the Shuhei and the gang attacking. If you read the manga, you see that Soifan tries to do some things too. And to be honest with you, it was very short and sweet within the manga, so I kind of would like to get more of context of what this is, or obviously probably Reishi, right? But more of like what it embodies with the eyes and whatnot. Is it something that Yuha is controlling? And I want to see more of a desperation towards this. I want to see everyone try and get involved. And that's kind of the picture that is painting for me, so to say. So let's get into these images, because I'm very excited to talk about them. First of all, we have a bunch of images in a particular order. First of all, we have Shunsui Kyoraku, which I would imagine this is within the Muken. I don't understand why it wouldn't be. Also, big things about this episode too, because it could be possible that we get rid of the red sky and we go back into a normal daylight, but probably not, because it's probably going to turn to black just like it did in the PV. So we might get a glimpse of daylight for a smidgen of the episode. But we have Kyoraku, what seems to be within the, it wouldn't be in the Muken because it would be purple, so it's kind of blue. Maybe it's gone nighttime. Maybe this is when Black Coffin happens. Who truly knows? There's a plethora, and there's one of Kisuke too, where, you know, I can kind of guess, but you just never truly know. Then we have Aizen within the amazing chair. Considering that he's flexing his reishi here, I wouldn't imagine that this is a Black Coffin. I would imagine that this is him potentially attempting to shoot down the Soul Palace. That's my kind of vibe that I get from this image. Obviously, they're all going to be scattered throughout the episodes. The last set of screenshots that we had were very, like, close together screenshots. So I imagine this is kind of showcasing Aizen's reishi. Maybe this is his first appearance within the chair. Maybe this is him trying to, again, bring down the Soul Palace. It's, you know, nor here nor there. But I know from reading the manga that this is going to be a very Aizen-centric episode. We got it from the poem of the last episode too. So I just know. I goddamn know that people are going to love this episode. People are going to be screaming. People are going to be reacting. People are going to be hype and gassed, especially with how Aizen protrudes himself within this episode, and also having Kisuke be like, oh, he's stronger than before he was sealed. That's going to be a big head spinner for a lot of people. Then we have Kisuke Urahara right here, kind of looking at something, and I imagine because he's not in the laboratory, this is him potentially looking at the next image that we're going to get, which is probably the Quincy's. Or he's either like referencing Aizen here, or looking at Aizen like, oh, he's more powerful than he was before, or he's looking at the Quincy's. It's a toss-up here or there. Again, a lot of these images so far are safe, such as the Kyoraku one, such as the Urahara one. The Aizen one's a bit of a spoiler, obviously a very gas image nonetheless, something you can talk about. The Kyoraku one and the Urahara one, not so much. Until we get into like Core 4 and things get really anime only, then it's going to be like, ooh, what's this character going to do? What's that character going to do? What's happening in this scenario? But I feel like they're going to use images that are predominantly within the manga because it's just a safe anticipation. The next one is, of course, Basby, Nanana, Letoto, and thank God Giselle is blurred and I can't see them correctly. But this is an interesting one. This happened in the manga. I was wondering what was going to be changed. Obviously, we saw Nanana get bodied last time by Zenbonzaku Kageyoshi, by Byakuya. And then, of course, when the Ashwailin happened, and we saw Robert. And again, is Robert down for the count? Because technically, if Nanana is down for the count, then technically Robert should be... Well, if Nanana's back, then technically Robert should be. But there was also a Q&A from Kubo's club outside that also said that usually the Ashwellen takes the power from the oldest to then the youngest. And considering that Robert is kind of shown as an old person and considering what happened to him in the manga, chances are he's probably gone. He's probably cooked, so that's it. But the thing is with Nanana is that Kubo drew him a death photo, which is a bit premature considering that, you know, whatever. If you're a manga reader, you know what happens to Nanana in this episode. I wonder why Kubo basically trolled us. Unless he was just, like, getting it out the way and he was, like, you know, death to Nanana. But, yeah, it's... Kubo kind of, like... Unless that was the point, right? Maybe it was for shock value. Maybe it was a talking point. But to be honest with you, even though we got to see Nanana do his morphine ability on Byakuya, and obviously it didn't work because he was wearing the Shinigami cloak, and he had a little fight with, obviously, Candice and Robert, I am glad that he is back because anything that showcases these Quincy's abilities more and kind of expands on them potentially, the better, right? Because I don't want a Robert situation. I mean, Robert was good. We still don't know what his script N means, right? We saw that he could do things, which is good. You know, K-Lab's like, yes, BBS, right? But again, Robert, good shit for him. Still don't know what his shit does. And there's a few people, like The Question, that had their things kind of elaborated a little bit, but not too much. So, you know, Nanana would have been on the verge of almost non-existent. So I'm glad that he's getting his part, so to say. And if it can be expanded to even a bit of degree, that'd be even cooler too. So then, yeah, we have a picture of those guys, and shout outs to those. And then we see Mayuri, and this looks like it has a red sky, so I'm going to assume that he's on top of the laboratory, and this is where Kisuke's like, oh, we don't have enough reishi, we can't open the gate. And then this is where Mayuri clicks the button and he's like, on top, because obviously the roof's been caved down, this is where it's like, oh yeah, I've got a Rietsu amplifier. So that's what I think of this screenshot. So overall, a good batch of images, something to talk about. Obviously, I'm glad that I got to talk about some of these images and what my thoughts were, and now my expectations. Obviously, I think that this is going to end, the episode's going to end at a certain point. Everyone's going to be excited for Aizen. I'm excited for Aizen. I can't wait for them to show and display the Shinigami fighting up against the blue goop. Unironically, I like to see... Come on, Tetsuzaman. Get that Shikai in there and do something, bro. Come on. This is your chance, Tetsuzaman. Do something, brother. Please. I know it's not going to happen, but hey, we can hope, right? And then we get on to Aizen. And then I want to see, like, the facial reactions of Aizen's return, a little bit of back and forth between some people. Byakuya's conversation with Kyoraku about, like, the insulting of the Gotei 13. Which, the more I think about it, it's kind of true. It's kind of like, really? Like, you're insult. I understand now what it means by you insulted us by bringing back Aizen. It's because we had to get a criminal to do a job that we couldn't do. And that's kind of the insinuation I believe that Byakuya entails. And hopefully that episode kind of expresses that a little bit more. But then, depending on how much they're going to add towards the end, we may be getting, if you know me, pause the video, hit it in the comment section down below. Ruruka fucking an Orihime fucking donut loving Ruruka.
Ruruka in the bunny outfit.
Ruruka in the bunny outfit. I'm so ready. I'm so ready, right? And I hope it goes, I hope it's just a smidgen. I just hope it's a smidgen because I want them to spend half the episode next obviously on Grimmjow too. We're going to get lots of Grimmjow. Like, yeah, we're gas for Aizen, but we're also going to get Grimmjow. And then we're going to get fucking Ruruka. And then next episode, I want the first half of just interactions with fucking Ruruka in a bunny outfit with the fucking... I want the wings to fucking flutter. Fucking flutter the damn wings and do the fucking... The bunny ears slapping Orihime. Oh my god, I'm so fucking ready for this. You don't understand. Be there for the live reaction. Be there for the motherfucking live reaction. Anyone that even leaks me a fucking image of this fucking girl before the air day, I'm going to fucking come to your house and do things that only your imagination could... Not sexual, right? Stop that. Anyway, tell me your thoughts in the comment section down below of what you think of this episode that's coming up. I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine dabbing hands. And then, as always, people, peace out.